Yes.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Sachin Jain. I'll be discussing optimization via simulation. So coming to the introduction, before that, I'll like to give you an example for this. Consider a material handling system. So a material handling system consists of large automated storage and retrieval devices, automated guided vehicles. So material handling involves short distance movement within a building or between a building and the transportation vehicle. We have a routing algorithms used to dispatch the automated guided vehicles. Alternative designs will be evaluated according to the AGV utilization, transportation delay for material, and the things needed to be moved, and overall investment and operation cost. So the goal in optimization while simulation is to minimize or maximize some measures of system performance, and system performance can be evaluated only by running a computer simulation. Optimization via simulation is a relatively new but already a vast topic and has commercial software built on it. So consider let x1, x2, xm be the controllable design variables. The output observed via the simulation is denoted by y of x1, x2, xm. To optimize this output performance, we have to find either with respect to x1, x2, xm is to maximize or minimize the mathematical expectation of the performance y. So coming to the strategies employed in optimization via simulation. The first one, combine all the performance measures into a single measure, the most common being cost. For instance, in the material handling system, the revenue generated by each completed product in MHS could represent productivity and be included as a negative cost. Coming to the second one, optimize with respect to one key performance measure, but then evaluate the top solutions with respect to secondary performance measures. For example, the MHS could be optimized with respect to expected cost, or the cycle time could be compared to the other top 5 designs. This approach requires additional information on more than just the best solution to be maintained. The third one, optimize with respect to one key performance measure. But consider only those alternatives that meet certain constraints on the other performance measure. For instance, the MHS could be optimized with respect to expected cost for those alternatives whose expected cycle time is less than a given threshold. Difficulties in optimization. Even when there is no uncertainty, optimization can be very difficult. If the number of design variables is large, the performance... just a minute. If the number of design variable is large, the problem contains a diverse collection of variable types and little is known about the structure of the performance function. Optimization via simulation adds an additional complication, like the performance of a particular design cannot be evaluated exactly, but instead it can be estimated. Because we have estimates, it is not possible to conclude with assurance that one design is better than another. And this uncertainty frustrates optimization algorithms that try to move in improving direction. One can eliminate this complication by making so many replication or long runs at each design point that the performance estimate has essentially no variance. Coming to the standards, the following are the standards that forces optimization via simulation to make compromise on the existence of sampling variability. Guarantee a pre-specified probability of correct selection. It allows an analyst to specify the desired chance of being right. Such algorithms typically require either that every possible design be simulated or that a strong functional relationship among the design applied. Guarantee asymptotic convergence. There are many algorithms that guarantee convergence to the global optimal solution as the simulation effort. These guarantees are useful because they indicate that the algorithm tends to get to where the analyst wants it to go. Optimal for deterministic counterpart. The idea here is to use an algorithm that would find the optimal solution if the performance of each design could be evaluated with certainty. An example for this might be applying the standard nonlinear programming algorithm to the simulation optimization problem. Coming to robust heuristics. Many heuristics have been developed for deterministic optimization problems that do not guarantee finding the optimal solution, but nevertheless been shown to be very effective on difficult practical problems. Some of these heuristics are randomness as part of this search strategy. Thank you.